Good afternoon, students. This is Arun, Assistant Professor, Department of Trichy, University Town. So in the previous class, I discussed about some starting methods or types of synchronous motors, static synchronous motors, single phase synchronous motors. So in that class, I discussed about split phase induction motor and next capacitor start induction motor and capacitor start capacitor on induction motor. And now in this class, I'm going to discuss two more. Types of single phase synchronous motors. Okay, so those two are permanent capacitor motor, and next one is shared pole motor. And after that, I will discuss some special types of motors in this one. Okay, so firstly, I will start with the first method, that is permanent capacitor motor. So this permanent capacitor motor is one of the type of synchronous single phase induction motor, single phase induction motor. So in this one, so in the permanent split capacitor motor, the capacitor and auxiliary winding are not disconnected after starting. So in the permanent split capacitor motor, the capacitor and auxiliary winding are not disconnected after starting. So in the previous class, I discussed about three methods. That one is a split phase motor, and next one is capacitor start motor, and next one is capacitor capacitor run motor. So in those three methods, in the first method, so in the last two methods, we used some capacitors series with the auxiliary winding. But actually, in all the diagrams, in all the circuit diagrams, we have two windings. One is main winding, and another one is auxiliary winding. So in those methods, we removed that auxiliary winding after starting the motor. Okay, but in this one, so in the permanent split capacitor motor, the capacitor and auxiliary winding are not disconnected after starting. So the construction can be simplified by omission of the centrifugal switch. Omission of the centrifugal switch. Omission is nothing but the remove. So since the motor having the capacitor, that too permanently. But since the motor having a capacitor permanently, the power factor, efficiency, and torque are improved. Okay, since the motor having a capacitor permanently, the power factor, efficiency, and torque are improved. So I will show the diagram. So this is the original permanent capacitor motor. In the practical cases, we are using this motor. Okay. So next, so I will show the two diagrams. Figure 1 and figure 2 shows the circuit diagram and phasor diagrams of permanent capacitor induction motor. So in this one, so this is the circuit diagram. So in this slide, we have I taken two diagrams. So on the left side, we have circuit diagram, and on the right side, we have rotor diagram or phasor diagram of this permanent capacitor motor. So in the circuit diagram, we are taking two windings. One is main winding, and another one is auxiliary winding. So main winding or running winding. At the same time, similarly, auxiliary winding or starting winding. So in this one, we are taking capacitor in series with the these are all auxiliary winding. So in this one, we are not using any switch. So in the previous three methods, we are using the switches. Centrifugal switch we are using in the previous three methods, but in this method, we are not using any switch. That is the omission of the switch, centrifugal switch from the circuit. So in this one, we have phasor diagram also. So here I am taking voltage as the reference phasor. So in this one, we have two currents. One is auxiliary winding current, and another one is main current. That is the main winding current. So in this one, the auxiliary winding current is leads the main current at an angle alpha, and the combination of this auxiliary winding and the main winding current is equal to total current of the winding. So in this one, so from this one, I am telling that since the main winding has low resistance and high inductive reactance, the current, that is I main, in main winding lacks the supply voltage less than 90 degrees. So I already said that in the circuit we are taking two windings. One is main winding and another one is auxiliary winding. So the main winding produces the main current, that is I main, and at the same time, auxiliary winding also produces the, or provides the auxiliary winding current, that is I auxiliary. So So in this one, the main winding has low resistance and high inductive reactance, and the current that is in the main winding, that is I main, lacks the supply voltage less than 90 degrees. So in the phasor diagram, you notice that one. So in this diagram, the voltage phasor lacks the main current, main winding current, less than 90 degrees. Okay. Next. So the auxiliary winding has a capacitor. So in this diagram, the auxiliary winding consists of one capacitor. Okay. So that capacitor has low resistance and high inductive. And it also consists of a capacitor, and it consists of the current, that is auxiliary current, I auxiliary. So this I auxiliary current leads the main winding current, that is I main. Okay, I auxiliary and I main, these are the currents in the auxiliary winding, at the same time in the main winding. So thus the phase angle between the two currents is alpha. So this phase difference is enough to produce a rotating magnetic field, RMF. Okay, this phase difference is enough to produce a rotating magnetic field. So the direction of rotation of this type of induction motor may be reversed. Okay, the direction of rotation of this type of induction motor may be reversed by reversing the connections of either the main or starting winding. Okay, so here I will show the diagram. It shows the top split characteristics of the permanent capacitor motor. So these are the top split characteristics of permanent capacitor motor. So in this one, the graph is drawn between top and synchronous speed. Okay, so next. So this type of, that means the permanent capacitor motor has high starting torque but less than the torque capacitor start motor. So this capacitor start motor is the second starting method of the single phase motor, single phase induction motor. Okay, so the permanent capacitor motor has high starting torque but less than that of capacitor start motor. So because of the permanent capacitor, it has a more power factor and efficiency at running. So because of the permanent capacitor, it has a more power factor and efficiency at running, and quieter and smoother in operation. So this type of motors are used in ceiling fans, pumping equipment, refrigeration, air compressors, blowers, etc. In those applications we are using this permanent capacitor motor. Okay, next one is shaded pole induction motor. So this is the last method of starting the single phase induction motor. So this type of motor consists of squirrel cage rotor. Okay, this type of motor consists of a squirrel cage rotor, and stator consists of a salient pole. Or projected poles. That is this one. So this is a shaded pole motor diagram. So in this one, I am taking a squirrel cage rotor and a stator, and in this one we are consisting of the two poles, that is north pole and south pole, and these are, here we have shaded band. So these shaded bands are connected to the poles. Okay, and next we are giving the single phase AC supply to the stator. Okay, next, in this one, a low resistance copper band called shading band. Is placed on each pole. So if you observe this diagram, here we are using a shaded band. So this shaded band is connected to both the poles. On each pole. So when a single phase supply is given to stator, of shaded pole motor, at that time an alternating flux will be produced in the stator pole. So here we are considering three instances, say T1, T2, and T3. Here we are considering three instances, T1, T2, and T3 during first cycle of a flux waveform. During the first cycle of a flux waveform. So here below I am taking the three time instants, these three waveforms at the time T1, T2, and T3. And on the right side we have the waveform for the flux with respect to time. Okay, in this one we are having the half sine wave. Angle between these time instants is 0 to pi. So here these three diagrams gives the time instants of the shaded pole induction motor. Okay. So coming to the first instant, that is at t is equal to t1 instant. So at this instant, the flux is increasing with respect to omega t. So at this instant, the flux is increasing with respect to omega t. So the rate of change in flux, that is d phi by dt. So the rate of change in flux, that is d phi by dt, is more. Hence, large EMF will induce it across shading band. Hence, large EMF will induce across shading band. This is that is shown in the t is equal to t1 instant. That is the left side first diagram. Okay. So in this EMF produces a circulating current in shading band. Okay. So whenever the flux is increasing, that means at this instant, at t1 instant, the flux is increasing with respect to omega t. So the rate of change in flux, that is d phi by dt, is more. Hence, large EMF will induce across shading band. So this EMF produces a circulating current in shading band and produces its own flux. So the direction of this flux is opposite to direction of main flux. Okay, the direction of the flux is opposite to the direction of main flux. So the main flux is more at the unshaded part and less at shaded part. So hence the overall magnetic axis is in unshaded part only, as shown in the figure 2, that is this one in this diagram. Okay. So next, coming to the second instant, that is T2 instant. So at this instant, the flux is increasing with slow rate. At this instant, the flux is increasing with slow rate, that is almost constant with respect to omega t. So the rate of change in flux, that is d phi by dt, is constant. So in the T1 instant, the EMF is increasing. Okay. And at the same time, flux is also increasing with respect to omega t. But at this instant, the rate of change in flux is constant. Okay. So hence, circulating current and its own flux in shading band is negligible. Okay. Hence, circulating current and its own flux in shading band is negligible. So main flux distribution is uniform and the overall magnetic axis lies at center of the pole only. So if you observe the second instant, that is T is equal to T2, in this one the magnetic axis lies at the center of the pole. So if you observe the first instant, the magnetic axis is placed aside of the pole. And next, coming to the third instant, that is T is equal to T3 instant. So at this instant, the flux is decaying with respect to omega t. So the rate of change in flux, that is d phi by dt, is more in negative direction. Hence, large EMF will induce across shading band. So this EMF produces a circulating current in shading band and produces its own flux in the direction of main flux. So there is less flux at unshaded part and more at shaded part. So hence the overall magnetic axis is in shaded part only, as shown in the diagram, that is this one, only in the shaded part. So here there is no presence of the magnetic axis in the prime instant T3. So this entire process is repeated for negative half cycle also. So up to now, we take it for the positive half cycle, and this process is repeated for negative half cycle also. So consequently, it produces an effect of rotating magnetic field, and the direction is from unshaded part to shaded part of the pole. So consequently, produces an effect of RMF, and the direction is from unshaded part to shaded part of the pole. So due to this, motor produces a starting torque and start rotating. So the torque speed characteristics of shaded pole motor is shown in the below diagram. So this is the characteristic diagram of the shaded pole induction motor. So in this one, the graph is drawn between percentage of torque versus synchronous speed. Here the synchronous speed is varying. Percentage of synchronous speed, the speed is varying between 0 to 100%. So hence the percentage of torque is also between 0 to 20. So here the curve is like this. So it is gradually increasing, the speed of the torque is increasing, the percentage of the torque is increasing with respect to the speed, synchronous speed, up to some point. After it will decrease to synchronous speed up to 100%. Okay. So the shaded pole motor is designed for 40 watts to 60 watts or less power ratings. Okay, the shaded pole motor is designed for 40 watts to 60 watts are less power ratings. So these motors are cheaper in cost, but its starting torque, power factor and efficiency are poor. That means about 30% only. Okay, next, this type of motors is used for small fans, toy motors, film projectors, hair dryers and record players, etc. In those applications, we use shaded pole induction motor. Okay. So these are the different methods for this single phase induction motor. Okay, and now we are moving to the special motors in the fifth chapter. That is, first one is AC series motor or universal motor. Okay, so in this one, if an ordinary DC series motor is connected to single phase AC supply, the current produced by the field winding and armature windings reverses almost at the same time. Okay, if an ordinary DC series motor is connected to single phase AC supply, the current produced by the field winding and armature windings reverses almost at same time. So the torque will be always in same direction. Okay, so however, the DC series motor cannot give good results when it used on AC supply due to following reasons. So here I will explain some, I will list some reasons why the DC series motor cannot give good results when it used on AC supply. So first one is, the first reason is the armature winding and field winding offers high reactance to AC. Okay, the armature winding and field windings offers high reactance to AC. So due to this high reactance, the operating power factor is low. The operating power factor is low, and the efficiency is poor. The second reason is the efficiency is poor. That means the poor efficiency is caused by increased hysteresis loss and eddy current losses due to alternating flux. So why the efficiency is poor when the DC motor connected to AC supply is the poor is caused by increased hysteresis loss and eddy current loss due to alternating flux. And third reason is sparking at brushes due to poor commutation. Sparking at brushes due to poor commutation. So in order to have satisfactory performance of DC series motor or single phase AC, okay, in order to have satisfactory performance of DC series motor or single phase AC, it needs some modifications, and the motor is called AC series motor. Okay, in order to have satisfactory performance of DC series motor or single phase AC, it needs some modifications, and the motor is called AC series motor. So here I listed some modifications. Okay, so the first one is to improve the efficiency, the hysteresis and eddy current losses have to reduce. okay, to improve the efficiency, the stresses and eddy current losses have to reduce. So this can be achieved by using silicon steel laminated poles. This can be achieved by using silicon steel laminated poles. And the yoke and poles were also laminated. The yoke and poles were also laminated. And coming to the second modification, the power factor can be improved by reducing the field and armature winding reactance. Okay, the power factor can be improved by reducing the field and armature winding reactances. And next, so in this one, the field winding reactance can be reduced by reducing the number of turns, but this reduces the field flux. So this results in increasing speed and reducing the torque. Okay, the field winding reactance can be reduced by reducing the number of turns, but this reduces the field flux. So these results in increasing speed and reducing the torque. So to keep the torque as constant, it is need to increase the armature turns proportionally. Armature turns proportionally. So this increases the armature winding reactance and produces severe armature reaction. So to neutralize the armature reaction, it is necessary to produce flux which in opposite direction using a separate winding. Okay, to neutralize the armature reaction, it is necessary to produce flux which in opposite direction using a separate winding. So that winding is called compensating winding. Okay, so the compensating winding is connected in series with armature winding, either conductively or inductively. Either conductively or inductively. So this is the actual universal motor we are using, the AC series motor. So in this one, here the commutator is placed. So this one is armature and this one is field winding. And here we have fan. And here at the top we have speed reducing gear is also there. Okay, this is the arrangement of the universal motor. Okay, so I said that previously, that is the compensating winding is connected in series with the armature winding. Okay, the compensating winding is connected in series with the armature winding. So this is the armature winding. Okay, and this is the compensating winding. And either conductively or inductively. In the first diagram, it is connected conductively. The compensating winding is connected to the motor conductively, to the series motor conductively. And the second diagram, series motor with inductively compensated winding. Okay, so this is a motor. At the above of the motor, we have armature winding, and below to the motor we have compensating winding, and the series field winding is also there. It is series to the motor. Okay, here we are applying a single phase AC supply. Okay, so in the inductively compensated winding, so in this one we are taking the same, but here the compensating winding is taken separately. Okay, same connections. So this is the vector diagram. So this is the vector diagram of the universal motor. So here I am taking the current I. So in the universal motor, the current is equal to armature current and series current, series field current. And next, here the terminal voltage, the current meets the terminal voltage at an angle theta. So here we have some drops, that is IRSA drop and IXSC drop and IRA drop and IXA drop and IRC drop and IXC drop, and finally we have the back EMF. Okay, so from the phase diagram, let ZSC is impedance of series field winding. So ZSC is impedance of series field winding, that is equal to, so you know already ZSC means it is the combination of resistor and reactor, that is RSC plus JXSC and ZA. So that is, ZA is impedance of armature winding. Impedance of armature winding, that is RA plus JXA. And coming to ZC, so it is the impedance of compensating winding, that is RC plus JXC. So when a single phase AC supply is given to universal motor, a current of I amperes passes and produces a drop as First one is I ZSC drop. So that is I RSC plus J into I XSC and I ZA drop, that is equal to I into IA plus J into I into XA. And finally we have I ZSC drop. So in this one, it is a combination of I RSC plus J into I XSC. Okay, the octet diagram of IXSC is what is shown in this one. Okay, these are the various drops we have. And next, coming to the performance characteristics. Performance characteristics of AC series motor or universal motor. So in this one, we are taking the characteristics, the performance characteristics in three manners. One is speed, armature current characteristics, torque, armature current characteristics, and next one is speed torque characteristics. So coming to the first one, that is torque armature current characteristics. Here the relation between torque and armature current of a series motor is, that is torque is directly proportional to phi into Ia. Phi into Ia. So that is, this relation is true for before saturation. Since the flux depends on armature current, that is phi is directly proportional to Ia. So the torque is proportional to square of the armature current, that is torque is directly proportional to Ia square. So, but after saturation, the flux becomes constant. So the torque is proportional to armature current only. So after saturation, this is torque is directly proportional to Ia. So the torque and armature current characteristics are parabola after saturation and linear after saturation. So the torque and armature current characteristics are parabola after saturation and linear after saturation. That is as shown in the torque armature current characteristics. Okay. So this one. Okay. So this one. So up to saturation, it is a parabola. The torque armature characteristics are parabola up to saturation. This one. And linear after saturation. Okay. This is the diagrammatic representation of this characteristics, torque versus armature current. And next, speed armature current characteristics. So we know that back EMF Eb is directly proportional to phi into N, but flux depends on armature current, that is flux is directly proportional to armature current Ia. So with the increase in armature current, the speed decreases as shown in speed armature current characteristics. So this is, so for DC operation we have this curve, and for AC operation we have this curve. Okay. And next we are coming to the speed torque characteristics. So the speed torque characteristics are derived from characteristics of speed armature current and torque armature current as shown in the figure. This is the diagram. So because of high starting torque of the AC series motor, it is used in electrical traction, cranes, escalators, points, etc. Because of high starting torque of AC series motor, it is used in electrical traction, cranes, escalators, points, etc. And the universal motor is used for the purposes where speed control and high values of the speed are necessary. And the various applications of the universal motor are as follows: the portable drill machine, and these motors are used in hair dryers, grinders, and table fans. And a universal motor is also used in blowers, washers, and kitchen appliances. Okay, so up to now we discussed about the different starting methods of the single phase induction motors, and after we discussed about the universal motor. And in the next class, I am going to discuss reluctance motor, stepper motor, and hysteresis motor. Okay, thank you. Thank you for watching this video.